Hi guys, welcome to the relaxation part of the Rocket Flow. It's great if you've just come to here to warm down before bed. It's amazing if you've joined me just after a rocket practice and you want that relaxation element. So if we come, we're gonna start in child's pose. Breathe deeply through some really beautiful stretching, releasing poses, and then have relaxation. Enjoy. So coming into child's pose in the middle of the mat, toes together, knees just wider than hip distance apart. If you need to, you can roll a cushion or a towel underneath, either placing it here or underneath your ankles. Heart reaches for the floor, head reaches for the ground. Breathing. We're going to take 5 mindful deep breaths with a breath hold in between. So deep breath into the back of the body. Feeling the shoulders swell, feeling the ribcage swell. And then hold that breath for 1, 2, 3. And then exhale, fully empty. Feel your whole body sink further into the mat and the shoulders release around the ears. And again, inhale. Feeling the lungs, feeling the shoulders broaden. Just allowing that intake of air, no forcefulness, holding there for 1, 2, 3. Emptying out fully. Breathing everything out. One more time. Inhaling fully, deeply, taking everything you need into the body. Holding there for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Exhale everything. Lovely. That'll be enough for those deep breaths. Breathe normally, breathe fully. Inhale, super slowly, roll up. Exhale, we're going to take our left hand, thread it underneath our right armpit and sink back down towards that child's pose. With that arm folded underneath our chin, with our head facing the shoulder. Relaxing there, 2 deep breaths, inhaling, exhaling. Feeling that sinking into gravity, inhaling. And exhaling. One more time, inhaling. And exhaling. Inhale, roll gently up, swapping the hands over, taking the right hand, threading it under the left armpit, sinking back to our child's pose with that arm tucked underneath our chin. Again, breathing at your own pace here. This is called Fallen Angel, and I love it, if not simply for that fact. Inhale, roll back up, coming into a tabletop position, hands under, shoulders, knees, hip distance apart. Just going to do some simple cat-cows. Inhale, lift through the heart. See how softly and smoothly you can move and breathe. Exhale, push the ground away, tuck the chin, arch the back. Empty by drawing the belly down. Inhale. I like to picture scooping ice cream with a perfect ice cream scoop that's warm so it all kind of moves. That kind of smoothness to your movement. Those hips draw forward towards the triceps as you push the ground away and arch your back. Tuck your chin, breathe into the space between your shoulder blades as you begin to move your movement forward. One more time. Imagine rolling your front of your elbows to the eye of your elbows forward as you come forward. Coming back to a tabletop position. Inhale, lift your right leg. Maybe if you're feeling strong, using the integrity of core, lifting your left hand. Big breath here, inhale, stretch out. And then exhale smoothly and slowly. As you exhale, bend to step your right foot forward beside your right hand, coming into a kind of lunge. We're just going to go into lizard pose. So bring those forearms down towards the ground. I'll show you this direction so you can see better. And just being careful, if this is too much for you, staying on your hands, letting the head bow slightly. Maybe rocking into the hips, wherever you are. Inhale, lengthen that front leg, draw yourself back, then have your hips stacked over your knee. You're stretching out that front leg now, that right leg, just rocking through the heel. I'm showing you by moving my hands. So my spine is long, it's not hunched over, but I'm rocking through the heel into the hamstring. And then gently exhale, bend that knee back again. We're going to take the right ankle towards the left wrist and come into pigeon pose. If this is too much for you, you can have the heel all the way into the hip. But I like a nice big stretch, so I keep my ankle out and create a 90 degree angle with my knees. Take an inhale here, lift, try and draw the left hip down to the ground. And exhale, fold forward, 5 deep breaths. 1, 2, coming in as deeply as it feels good for you. Keep those elbows bent if you need to. 3, 4, and 5. Inhale, walking out, drawing that ankle in and rolling over, coming back to your tabletop position to do the same thing on the other side. Inhale, lengthen the left leg and the right hand if you're feeling crazy. And again, use an extra inhale to stretch super through both of them. And then exhale to plant that hand back down, but step your left foot by your left wrist, coming into a lizard, adjusting. Take that knee, that back knee down if you need to. And maybe we bring the forearms down as well. Adding a little rock if that feels good. When you're ready again, coming up onto your hands, pushing your hips back so they're stacked over your bent knee. And again, just rolling really gently through the heel. Super yummy. And when you're ready, bending that front knee again, bringing it down, right ankle to left, no, left ankle to right wrist. Coming into your pigeon pose on the other side. Take an inhale, lift. Exhale, fold. 5 deep breaths. 1, 2, 3. And 5. On the inhale, lifting your body up. Again, tucking that ankle safely in towards your groin before stepping into your tabletop. We're going to sit back onto the heels. Take a breath here. We're going to do some shoulder rolls. So inhale, the shoulders all the way up. And exhale, all the way back. All the way up. All the way back. getting to the edge of every movement and then swapping direction. And then when you're ready, coming down onto your back, taking the feet hip distance apart, bringing them just so you can tickle them with your fingertips, the heels, just behind the buttocks. And we're just going to do some nice bridge postures. So three times on the inhale, lifting your hips. And on the exhale, melting down. Inhale, lifting your hips, pressing into the surface of the feet. Exhale down. Every last bit of exhale out. Last time, inhale. And exhale. Final thing we're going to do is a lovely twist. So reach your hands out to the side. Take your right leg, cross it over towards the left. Let your left leg just fall and follow. And gaze to the right. Use your exhale and feel like you're wringing out the center of your body. So as you exhale, your rib cage moves towards the right. Your knees ground towards the left. One more super big inhale. Breathe it all in. In and in and in. And exhale, blow it out. For every last drop of air. Inhale, bringing it back, stacking the knees behind the hips again, or above the hips. And then taking the opposite direction, left leg crosses over towards the right, let the right leg fall and follow, and comes over in the opposite direction, breathing for five. Grounding with the exhale, four, three, and one. Inhale, coming back to center. Squeezing those knees into the chest. Maybe even taking a happy baby, holding the edge of the feet and letting the knees come into the armpits. You've got all the time in the world. Slowly, gently. And then when you're ready, allow your feet to fall towards the ground. Hands out to the side, lift the shoulders, tuck them underneath, lift the hips, round them towards the ground. Inhale for one, two, three, four, five. Hold as long as you think is okay. So I'd say about six or seven counts for one, two, three, four, five, six. Seven. Exhale, melt it all away, let it all ground down. Big breath out. You are in your relaxation, your final pose, your shavasana. Take as long as you need here. Let the body unravel. Let the mind settle. Let the eyes grow heavy. You are safe. You are exactly where you are supposed to be. All you have to do now is breathe. Thank you very much. If you want to make any donations, they can be done via PayPal in the links below.